A very good morning, children. So, as we are done with our chapter 12, the next chapter which I'm going to start is chapter 3, HCF and LCM. Okay. This is the chapter which is not going to be in the syllabus for the upcoming examination. Only chapter 2 and chapter 12 are there. Okay. This chapter is not going to be in your examination, but as we have some time to start the revision, I'm just continuing the portion. So continue your CW with this new chapter. No need to leave any kind of spaces, just start in a fresh space. Okay, so apart from that, we are going to start the concept of HCF first. Okay, very important concept. This is the one which you might have already come across in your previous classes, but the approach of finding HCF is going to change from 5th class. So please observe the sessions carefully. So first of HCF and LCM, we are going to start with HCF. You already know HCF means highest common factor. Okay, so in HCF, H indicates highest and C indicates common and F indicates factor. Okay, so it is also called as greatest common divisor. Okay, greatest common divisor, GCD. Okay, even GCF is also there. Whatever it is, HCF means highest common factor or greatest common divisor, which is GCD. So if someone asks you to find HCF or GCD, the procedure is same. So in HCF, if you observe, in HCF, if you observe, we have three words, namely highest common factor. Okay, I think you might have already come across finding the factors for given numbers. So let us repeat the concept again to have a firm foundation to move ahead with this chapter. So factors, I want to explain the same using an example. Look, for example, if I ask you to find the factors of 10, okay, factors of 10, how will we write? So 10 we can write as, we always start with ascending order, isn't it? 1 into 10, which gives us 10. And again, in 2 table, 2 into 5 gives us 10, isn't it? So, the factors of 10 are 1 into 10, 2 into 5. After 2, 3, in 3 table, we can't see 10. In 4 table, we can't see 10. Whereas, again, 5 table will come. Again, in 10 table. So, instead of writing 5 into 2 and lastly 10 into 1 again, these are already available in this multiplication system. So instead of writing or repeating them again and again, what we'll take is, okay, we will take like this, okay, down arrow, that means you have to take these as factors, and up arrow is the, okay, right side numbers are also to be considered as factors. Okay, we have the factors of 10 as 1 2 5 10. Hope you understood, children. In which multiplications we got the value of 10, I wrote here. And instead of repeating this 5 into 10 and 10 into 1 again, we are taking it as common things, like by showing arrows. Look. So 1 into 10, 2 into 5, again 5 into 2 gives us 10, again 10 into 1 gives us 10. Okay. So this kind of repetition is wrong. these two things, as we are already done with this in reverse order also, we have to take only once. Okay. So, the factors of 10 are 1, 2, 5 and 10. Okay. The factors of 10 are 1, 2, 5 and 10. Now, I want to take another number, for example, 15. Okay. 15. So, the same, always 1 comes 1, 15 is 15. 1 into 15 gives 15. In 2 table, we can't cancel 15. Again, in 3 table, 3 into 5, 15. Okay. After that, 5 into 3. So, reverse of this. And again, 15 into 1. So, the factors of 15 are going to be 1, 3, 5 and 15. So these are the factors of 10 and 15. Now what is the next letter? Common. We are done with first word factor. So which we found for the numbers 10 and 15. Look, what are the common factors of 10 and 15 which we wrote here? Okay. Of these things, we can say that 1 is the common factor for both 10 and 15. 2 is not the common factor because it is available here, but it is not there in 15. Again, 5 is the common factor. Now, 10, 15. Again, these are not the factors of both 10 and 15. The common factors are only 1 and 5 for 10 and 15. Now, of these common factors, which is the highest factor? Highest means biggest or greatest. Of 1 and 5, which is the biggest? 5. So, 5 is the HCF of 10 and 15. 5 is the HCF of 10 and 15. This is the method which we have been following so far. But from 5th standard, we won't follow these methods. Okay? Okay? So, there exists a variety of methods like prime factorization, okay, short division, like that kind of stuff. Before understanding or going into that, I want to just recap the things of what exactly the highest common factor means. Okay? So, what is the HCF definition now? HCF is the greatest number. HCF is the greatest number. HCF is the greatest number that can divide each of the given numbers exactly. Okay, for this I will send you a document, children. Don't copy anything from the board. So each of the given numbers exactly. This is the meaning of or the definition of HCF. Now, in this, we need to learn one more concept. Before actually going into the procedures, you should have firm knowledge regarding the concept of HCF first. Look, I want to find the HCF of 9 and 18. Find the HCF of 9 and 18. So the first method which we are going to start to find the HCF is using prime factorization method. Both are same. Simply they will call prime factorization or they will specify prime factorization method. So, find the HCF of 9 and 18 using prime factorization. First, we need to understand what exactly the prime factorization means. See, factorization means finding factors only. Then what is prime means? we will make use of prime numbers, you know. Okay, so the prime numbers are the numbers which are divisible by 1 and the number itself. Look, for example, we'll start with 2. 2 is the number which is divisible by 2 and 1. Next, 3. 3 is the number which is divisible by 1 and 3 itself. 5. 5 is the number which is the number that is divisible by 5 and 1. Okay, 7. If you are confused about this, look. What are the factors of 2? If I ask you to write the factors of 2, you will start writing like this. 1 into 2. 1 twos are 2. Again, that's all. 2 into 1 only. We won't get 2 in any other table except 1 and 2 table. Hence, the factors are going to be 1 and 2. Now, factors of 5, for example. Factors of 5. If we start writing, always start with 1 table only. 1 into 5. In 2 table, we can't cancel 5. In 3 table, we can't get 5. In 4 table, we can't get 5. Again, 5 into 1 only. So, the factors of 5 are 1 and 5. If you observe for 2, 1 and 2. For 5, 1 and 5. So, 1 and 2 are going to be the factors of such. Okay, 1 and the number itself are going to be the factors for prime numbers. Okay, so we will use prime numbers to find the HCF of given numbers. Very easy, children, if you understand. I want the HCF of 9 and 18 using prime numbers. This is etc. You can, okay. Usually we won't go beyond 7, but sometimes it may be required. So, prime numbers, list of prime numbers. Look, what is the first number to which we have to find 9? To find the HCF 9. Look. We are going to make a table like this. Look. The digit is an odd number or even number. It is an odd number. So start with odd prime first. What is the first odd prime in the set of prime numbers? 3. So we can write 3 threes are 9. Look. 3 threes are 9. Isn't it? And lastly, we can cancel 3 in one table. 3 ones are. Okay. So we have to cancel this till we get 1. This is the benchmark. 3 threes are 9 first. Again, 3 ones are 3. Okay, look. Three threes are 9 we got. Again, we have a chance of cancelling this 3 in 3 table. How many times? 3 ones are 3. Okay, these arrow marks are not required. For your understanding only, I am keeping this. So, how can we write 9 now? Check the numbers on the left side of these lines, which is 3 multiplied by 3. Hope you are understanding, children. 9 is an odd number. And the first odd number available in set of prime numbers is 3. As there is a chance of cancelling 9 using 3 table, I started this cancellation with 3. If it is not possible with 3, we have to check the next odd prime. And the other number for which I want to find HCF is 18. For this thing also, you have to write like this. Okay, don't worry, children. Looks complicated, but as the sessions are going on, you can do this very easily. Now look, 18 is an even number. What is the even prime or the first even prime in the prime numbers 2? Actually, 2 is the only even prime. So, we can cancel 18 in 2 table. 2, how many times is 18? 2 9s are 18. So, you will write 9 here. Again, draw a line like this. Now, we have 9, which is an odd number. What is the first odd prime number? 3. And there is a chance of cancelling 9 in 3 table. So, 3, how many times is 9? 3 is a. You will write that 3 here. Next, we can cancel 3 in 3 table. So, 3 ones are 3. Okay, hope you are understanding, children. In the coming classes, we usually don't follow up to one also. You can find the HCF very easily once you are quite clear with the process of prime factorization. Now look, so how can we write 18 now? How can we write 18? 18 we can write as the product of all these left hand side terms. 2 into the second term, 3 into 3. If you write 1, the same will come, so no need of writing 1. This 1 indicates we are done with the prime factorization process. Now look, so we extracted or we prime factorized 9 as 3 into 3 and 18 as 2 into 3 into 3. The reason why they are calling prime factorization is, if you observe the factors of given numbers, 3 is a prime number, here 3 is a prime number, 2 is a prime number, 3 is a prime number, again 3 is a prime number. Hence the name prime factorization. Now, we are done with prime factorization. How can we find HCF by taking the prime factorization? Now look at the board. How we got the 9? 9 is written as 3 into 3 here. Now 18. 18 we got the value as 2 into 3 into 3. 2 into 3 into 3. Now if you observe, children, here also we have 3 and here also we have 3. Okay. Here also we have 3. One pair. This 3 and this 3 I made one pair because 2 is not available in 9. Again we have 1, 3, one more 3 and here also we have one more 3. So we are going to pair up this. Now, 3, 3. So take that common 3 here, 3. Here also 3, 3. Take that common 3. Okay, as we have 2, we should not take 2 threes, children. Of the pair, we have to take only 1 3. Here in this pair, I took 1 3 and from this pair, I took another 3. So 3 into 3, 9. This is the HCF of 9 and 18. HCF of 9 and 18 is 9. Hope you are understanding, children. This is the way how we have to find the HCF using prime factorization. So for this I will send some notes to you. Just copy it for today. Tomorrow I will show you more examples and then we'll proceed further. Here there is one point, children. Look, what are the numbers for which we want to find the HCF? 9 and 18. 9 and 18. If you observe the HCF, it is one of the numbers which we took. Look, 9 and 18, the HCF of 9 and 18 is 9 again. Okay, the logic behind this is, what are the numbers we took? 9, 18. Okay, as the situation came, I am explaining this point, children. Don't take too much burden on this. So, 9 and 18. We can cancel this 18 using 9, isn't it? We can cancel 18 in 9 table. So, out of the given 2 numbers, if one number is factor of other number, okay, if one number is factor, that means factor means, as we have discussed, we can cancel 18 using 9. So, 9 is the factor of 18, isn't it? So, the smallest of the 2 numbers will be the HCF. Okay, of the given 2 numbers, if one number is the factor of other, okay, then of the given number, smallest number will be the HCF of that number. Okay, so there exists one more point like this, which I am going to discuss tomorrow, children. Just watch the video carefully again and again until you understand this process of prime factorization, which helps you to solve the excess problems easily. Okay, that's all for today, children. Have a great day.